Hello everyone, here you are with Claro Beauty and Life. Thank you very much for tuning in. Today we're gonna be doing a soft look with red lipstick. The reason I'm doing this is because following in another video, I'm gonna be showing off the true velvet lipsticks from Lisa Eldridge. And so I wanted to do the face first, so then the next video will be just the lipsticks. And I have the Dior 999 lipstick, which is famous and he has gone through time and I love it. I actually have the full size, which is now escaping me, of course, because we're starting to do the video. And I have the smaller size. So, oh, they're both small here. Ha ha ha. So this is a 999. And I have used it through the years, but today we also gonna be featuring the Quad Cashmere, Soft Cashmere 669 for the soft look. And I hope, and other goodies, you know, for bronzer and everything else that I will be using. So if you're interested in this, keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do, I just got this sample, which I loved it so much that I actually ordered the full size. It's on its way. And this is the Bobbi Brown Extra Illuminating Moisture Balm. I received this sample and I love when I get a sample that I actually like. Usually I receive samples and I'm like, not really interested. But this is one that has been successful. So I tried this and I really loved it. I used to always wear Laura Mercier kind of illuminating primer when I wanted a little more glowy look or a little more healthier look. But I have to say, I'm really enjoying this one. I've been using it for 3 or 4 days and I ordered the full size. So that tells you something. I'm sure you're gonna be hearing me talk about it often because now I'm gonna be using this. So I'm gonna put just a tiny amount and we're gonna just put it right here, kind of where you will put the highlight. And then I just spread it out. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit red here, but that's usually how I get. And that's why I cover up a little bit, even if I'm just going for a natural look. And so you will be watching how I do this. So the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm not very big on concealer. However, I do use two that I use it all the time. One is this Clair de Peau concealer because they also have another one, which is more for a radiant kind of concealing, but it has a lot of light. So I like that for other looks or for other times, but usually if I wanna cover, you see the little blue or purple under my eyes, then I use the actual concealer. My color is Ivory. The other thing I use, and I mentioned in another video, is the Westman Atelier foundation. However, I do use it for concealing and spots and things like that, not really like a full foundation. So I'm not using that today because I want a little more full coverage. I mean, full coverage, what I mean is put it everywhere evenly because I want those red lips to really show. So today we're gonna be using the concealer. And what did I decide to use for a mirror? I guess I forgot again to bring a mirror. So we're gonna be using for now the quad here, at least you see the brand. So I'm gonna put a line and a line, and I start with this. Sometimes you can put the concealer after you put the foundation. I like to put it under, so when I put the foundation, kind of everything evens up. And you see that I use so little product of most of the stuff that I don't really cover completely, but just enough. I mean, I don't go to many real parties, or mostly I go with friends, so they know what I look like most of the time. And so is okay. And you know, makeup for me is for fun. I really enjoyed it. I mean, I know people do it to look better or just to be presentable, but for me is has been a true joy. I actually watch a lot of YouTube videos on makeup, and I get memorized by the different textures and colors, and that's what I enjoy. I remember at some point my husband was thinking there was something wrong with me if I would observe the screen of the TV for a while, you know, like 5 minutes, and he would be like, "You're just watching a screen and you don't change it or you don't move it, or you know, like, are you okay?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I'm analyzing every single color," you know, which is interesting because the actual colors of makeup, even what you're hearing here, obviously varies depending on the lighting, the person, many features. So even if the actual brand posts the swatches of a color, it will look different on you, or it will even look different in person. I mean, it's just how it is. But still, to me, it was just learning about cooler, warmer, orange, pink, you know, peach. It was really fascinating. Maybe I missed that as a child, or maybe I just didn't play enough with colors. Something like that. So I'm just retouching a little red dots. I think those are, I was out doing some errands, and I think that's from the glasses. I have very sensitive skin. So the lighting, sometimes the heat, sometimes just putting anything in my face will make it an exaggeration of what's happening in my skin. But hey, I'm a sensitive person. All right, so today we're gonna be using the foundation of Lisa Eldridge. And, I'm sorry. This is the highlight. Never mind. We're gonna be using the foundation of Drew Drop Foundation from Surratt. This is one of my favorites. I actually discovered this foundation through Michelle Wong. If you haven't heard about her, you can go and search for her because she has a great channel. I've been following her for years now. So this is a drop foundation, so I'm